The tooth has a big composite filling, but we wanna prep this tooth and to keep the margin on the tooth, not on composite. How to do this? Please follow this episode of the BG Dental Tip and you will see everything step by step. Dear friends, welcome to our new episode of the BG Dental Tips. And this time I will show you some interesting episodes related to tooth preparation, especially when we have composite restorations and we want to make our prep and the finish line on the tooth surface rather than on composite. So here you can see two central incisors filled with a resin composite, but I would like just to clarify that this is a case of the full mouth rehabilitation when we raised vertical dimension of occlusion. That's why some of teeth were prepped with for the, let's say, semi-crown or three-quarter crowns. Let's take a look on these central incisors from the palatal surface, where you can see that the one is endodontically treated and the palatal surface is completely covered with composite, and you can see some element like fiber pole. So that was an indication to do a crown in that particular case, but the adjacent tooth and then adjacent teeth were prepped also with a, let's say, palatal coverage because of the function, because of the static and dynamic contacts. So let's see what happens. This is just after preparation, and you can see that on the tooth number 11 we still have the composite material on the lateral, or sorry, on the mesial side, and since we have a concept that is called deep margin elevation, and there are some studies showing you that we can keep our preparations on composite. Me personally, I prefer in the front area, in the anterior teeth, to keep my margins on the teeth, not on the composite, especially if we have an enamel there. So this is the trick, okay? So we can see that video now. That's the almost final stage of the preparation. I was using the electric motor, increasing handpiece, the red diamond bore. That's why you may not see a bleeding, by the way. We spent a lot of time explaining this and developing this protocol actually for our colleagues, because we still have a lot of questions how we can make preparations with almost no bleeding if we move our finish line into the sulcus. So just to remind you one more time, the low speed, okay, electric motor, that's essential, it's must, electric motor, and then a red diamond bore. And that's the trick, by the way. You can see here a fluorescent filter, a fluorescent light that comes from the microscope. And this fluorescent light shows me where is the composite. So in that case, I'm able to do precise preparation on the mesial side, keeping my margin on the tooth, not on the composite. So the trick here and the tip here of this episode is related to utilization of the fluorescent light. If you have fluorescent filter on your microscope, it's perfect. If you don't have the fluorescent filter on the microscope, what you can use for that, you can use the fluorescent lighter actually, which you can buy on AliExpress, or there are some light curing units like curing lamps with a function of the UV light. And this UV light highlights fluorescent composite, and you can do your preparation or caries excavation also, removal of the old restorations using that very practical trick, which is really, really, really good. You can see again here how beautiful it is to see the composite with a fluorescent light. Okay, so here we have an image with a double cord. In a previous episode, I think we were covering the necessity in some cases to use a double cord technique before you scan or before impression. So that's the case indicated to that, because our preparations were inside the sulcus, almost at the full depth of the sulcus. That's why before the final impression, okay, or in our case we scan, before the final scan we used the second cord to expose the margins better. And now you can see exactly the beauty of your utilization of the UV light and the enamel that I was able, just let me zoom it, okay, so I was able to keep enamel, and actually not to keep enamel, but to keep my margin on enamel. So here you can see enamel, here you can see composite, and that was the goal of this preparation in the mesial aspect of this tooth, to keep the preparation margin on the tooth, ideally on enamel, and I was able to do that with a fluorescent light. If you are interested in the preparation techniques for crowns, for veneers also, for overlays, we have very beautiful, very practical hands-on course that is called the Big Prep course, and I invite you to attend this course where you can learn a lot of tips and tricks related to the preparations on hands-on, completely hands-on, 100% hands-on course with phantoms, with microscopes, with magnification, electric motors, and so on and so on. So I'll be happy to meet you here in Prague in our BJ Academy, and see you next time. May the dental force be with you.